everyone, and welcome back to another amazing episode of Quiet on the Set. I am, of course, your host, Yoni Bench. And, today I've been told that I've kind of crossed a few lines. So for our next guest, I'm going to summon him in a very unique way. So if you'll please introduce our next guest. Welcome, Joseph.
How did I get here?
Don't even question that. Joseph, we are in a realm beyond your wildest imagination now. Anything is possible. Look at the sky. Look at the floor. I know you're not used to seeing these things because you come from Detroit, you said?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, Joseph Corman from Detroit.
I was just in my room, and how did I get here?
Very interesting questions, Joseph, but I'm afraid that I'm the host and you are the interviewee. So if we will commence with the interview, good things are going to happen. Hopefully.
I didn't sign up for this.
I was hoping I wouldn't have to use this.
I didn't even sign up for this. I don't know how I literally just...
Joseph Corman, now that I've, brought you to your senses, I was told that you hail from the netherworld of Detroit. What would you actually be able to tell us about? Cars? Is that?
Yes, we have cars.
Fascinating. Do those cars, they have four wheels, yes?
Usually they do, yeah.
Usually they have four wheels, and they run on...
the ground.
Joseph, I see that you're a little behind the times, but as you can see here, none of the cars run on the ground. They actually use a really efficient method called fossil fuels. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I have been told not to endorse any official sponsors, but I must say that I am really, really getting a lot of mileage out of my car using Shell fossil fuels. So, Joseph Corman, I hear that you come from a really, really vast corn farm.
My last name is Corman.
Yeah, sure. Can you tell us about your famous canned corn recipe?
These are vegetarian baked beans. Like, this is not whatever you just told me it was.
So, Joseph, your famous corn recipe, I hear, requires exactly 2 ounces of human blood. Is that correct?
No, it requires 3 ounces of human blood.
Well, where do you get this human blood? That's what our viewers desperately want to know, so they can make their own canned corn at home and drive you out of business.
So, sometimes I'm just sitting in my room, casually, on a regular day, and then, out of nowhere, someone snaps their fingers and I end up on a couch on some random balcony.
Where do you get all these silly stories from, Joseph? Yes?
When those talk show hosts are just so incredibly not nice to me. Basically, I have a needle in my pocket at all times, and I jab it into the annoying talk show host. And then, baked beans, not corn, it's beans.
Joseph. There are many ways to describe corn. Canned corn, popcorn, the aforementioned corn. What was that? Hold on, my tripod is talking to me. What was my tripod saying?
You're human. Okay, that sounded bad. Your three-dimensional videographer is suggesting that you add corn schnitzel to the list.
I have no idea what that is. Joseph, I hear that you not only are a famous corn farmer, but you are also a world-renowned videographer. Now tell us, these video logs that you've been doing, where was the inspiration for them?
So I was on a bus. And out of nowhere, I just had to pee really badly. And luckily, my friend Seb Bell happened to be sitting there and had just finished his water. And I was like, hey.
Is this going to be safe to air on video?
No.
More answers to not be answered.
Oh. Essentially, what happened was... And then I sat back down and I was like, man, this would make great content.
Now these vlogs, as you call them, would you say that they might be competing with other forms of digital content?
No idea what you're talking about.
Oh, really, really? No idea what you're talking about? Then What are you doing? What's that in your hand, Joseph?
Hey, Jonathan Tyler.
Hey, let's get that camera out of here.
What do you have to say to the camera? Wait, hold on!
We are experiencing some technical difficulties. Please stand by. Now, Joseph, I've noticed that these, monstrous creations that you've made actually have some decent camera work. Would you by any chance be interested in a job? I could use with some replacement around here.
Are you talking about me?
Tripods don't talk, Ellie.
Shut up, tripod!
Sorry. I try.
Joseph, back to the question at hand.
You summoned me here out of nowhere. I didn't even know that was possible. And then you asked me to work for you? What, do you think I'm some kind of joke? You think I want to just talk about beans or corn?
Okay, we only have room for one emotionally unstable person.
I can't
on the show.
Do it. I'm out of here.
Okay. Well, it looks like our show is going to have to end a little early, but at least this saves me the trouble of having to kill another, eject another person. Until next time, folks, I've been Yoni Bench. That was, gosh darn, I already forgot his name, but we'll see you next time.
You don't even have the decency to remember my name after summoning me after all this time.
We'll see you next time on Quiet on the Set. I think I've got to work on my interperson skills.